Okay. What's up, YouTube? HPJ here. There's no beating around the bush this time, you guys. Welcome to my Yugitubing experience. And you know what? It's not been easy for me these last couple of months. For the last couple of years, it's been a back and forth. But I made it. And I want to share that experience with you guys. You know, Yugitubing is not easy for anyone. Being a YouTuber is not easy as it seems. Anyone who says it is, well, guess what? They're lying, because they've been through it. They may not have been through it as much as I have, but yeah, I mean, yeah. I'm sorry, I don't want to sugarcoat it. I don't want to sound like I'm being pretentious, but at the end of the day, I work hard for a lot of the things that I've done when it comes to being here on YouTube. Whether people like it or not, whether people accept a lot of the choices of the things that I've said or done, at the end of the day, I have to stick by what I've done. If I've proven wrong, then I've proven wrong. But, you know, sometimes there's been a lot of these back and forths and a lot of yelling and screaming through constant videos. Some people have given great advice. Some people have given horrible. Some things I won't play. Some things I will play. It's all about me and how I feel at that time. So I ain't gonna stress it. I'm not going to drag it down through the shithole. It's just, yeah, like, my experience has not been peaches and cream. My experience has not been the most dandy of dandies. And through it all, if I could change some things, I would. But I've learned a lot from a lot of things. And the one thing that I do say I have learned is that if I don't appreciate the things that I've done, no one else can appreciate them. I have to be very aggressive. I can be very aggressive at times. I can be very opinionated at times. That's just life. And if anyone, you know, feels like that's not how to conduct myself, well, guess what? I'm still here for a reason. What works for some people doesn't work for everyone. And you can't control me. You can't control what I say, how I feel, or what I've done. You know, that's just life. And there's nothing more to it. So, I think over the last couple of years, some things I do want to just explain to people, especially those who watch the channel, is that my channel is very casual set. I used to be a competitive player. I think the last time I was ever really competitive was when Perform Mage was a deck. And I think at that time I was still playing Harpies, because I had all that built. And then I had the Pendulum stuff. And the Pendulum stuff started to get real easy once a lot of the stuff either got A, reprinted, 2, half of it got banned and limited, and then 3, once I started collecting a lot of the stuff and purchasing a lot of the stuff, it just got a lot easier. So, for anyone who does ask the question of, do I do other deck profiles? I sure do. And they sit right here in this little cascade of a playlist that has all of those other decks that I've played. I've played Sky Striker, I've played Mandolce, I've played Monarchs, I've played Kaiju variants, I've played a lot of just here and there stuff. And I wanted people to know that it is here. And I was very upset when a comment was listed saying that, oh, you play other decks. Yeah, I play other decks. You must be new to the channel, because I've played a lot of these. Just people have to look. You guys have to look and see what stuff I've played. You know, and just because I have Puzzles and Dragons on the channel doesn't mean I strayed away from Yu-Gi-Oh. It's just, I need a break. That's all. I need a break from a lot of things. And I need a time to appreciate other things that I've done, so that way I can have a breather. Because every YouTuber needs it, every Yu-Gi-Oh player needs it. And that's just pretty much how it is. When I look at a lot of the content that I produce when it comes to Harpies, some people may not like it, some people will like it, but I'm always going to just do me and enjoy what I do. When it comes to a lot of the other deck profiles, same thing. When it comes to what I make a deck profile of, I have to be interested in the deck in order for me to want to build it. And that comes with a lot of stuff. Like, Skystriker Aces was something I did on a random. I never thought it would be a competitive deck, honestly. When it did hit competitive status, I think only a couple of weeks later, I lost out on Engage, I lost out on Widow Anchor, and the only one I probably could afford in its set up is Afterburner. I do know Kaizen, that's the Earth one. She's going to come out soon. And I'm sure she's going to be really easy to pick up because her effect is god awful. But she is still a Skystriker Ace, so if she can help me fill up the graveyard, perfectly fine. If I can benefit from her, even better. She may not have the best effect, but she still is a useful monster. Regardless. And that's just my opinion. And some people may not like that, but that's called life. And if you don't really like someone's opinion, sometimes it's better not to address it or talk about it. And then sometimes when it comes to trolls, sometimes they need to be put in their place. And I'm one of those people to put in their place. And the funny thing about this is a couple of days ago, I was talking to a friend and he told me not to do that. And honestly, I'm sorry, but no, I'm not like other YouTubers. I'm not like other Yu-Gi-Oh! Players. I don't just be quiet because it helps a fine medium. That's just not how I operate. And I think that's for a large portion of why people do like to associate with me. Is because I don't filter. I'm sorry. I don't cater to everyone because I'm not supposed to. I'm not dedicated to cater to everyone and everything. I just come on here, I do me, and I be done with it. And, you know, that's it. Whether it's deck profiles that aren't Harpy, deck profiles that are Harpy, I do me, I speak it, and I keep it going. Sometimes I can be harsh, but it's how you address the situation, how you address someone when you're communicating with people, especially when it's not in face, because I can take one thing and go crazy. Now, if you're going to leave, for example, a 15-paragraph line of things, it's not going to work. No, I'm sorry. Instant remove comment, because that is just crazy how some of these videos, I see them, and they're just like these 15 comments. And these long paragraphs, it's like, oh my god, why did I click to read more? It was not worth it. Then you just got the trolls, and they troll. Sometimes you gotta deal with them, too. It's just a part of being a YouTuber. It's part of being a YouTuber in general. And, you know, don't shame the casual. So I'm very casual. And I have no shame in that. And I don't regret nothing. At all. I enjoy what I do. I enjoy the things I've done. And over the last 9 years, I have no regrets of it. As I look on to the future of it, and just looking forward, the one thing I can say positively will still happen is, if I like something, I'm going to build it. Because I'll tell you guys right now, when those structure decks come out for the Salamence Great, that's that fire type archetype coming out soon. We're in the structure deck, you know, the reprinted Ash Blossoms. Yeah, I'll be running that. I don't see why not. Pick up a 3 of those, have 3 common Ash Blossoms, and then build the deck from there. Yeah, it's gonna be fun. You probably won't see a physical build of Skystriker Aces, because until Widow Angels like drop heavy, that's probably the only time you'll ever see me legitimately do that. And then outside of that, I mean, the most physicals you'll see are Harpie Dad profiles that are going to be physical and digital, the Grade Keepers and stuff like that. And just anything else that I piques my interest, then I'll go from there. So, you know, that's like the big gist of it. For anyone who is subscribing to the channel or new to the channel and you see this video, I just want you guys to know that my best advice for any of you who want to get into Yugitubing is just be you. And don't let anyone ever tell you otherwise. Put a smile on your face. Be as much of you as possible. You don't have to fake anything. You don't have to sugarcoat anything. Just be yourself. And I mean, 9 years now, and that's how I got to where I am. Just being myself. Some people may not like it. Some people might like it. Some people like it. Some people hate it. That's just life. Yes, I'm pretty much done here. I think I've said, for the most part, everything I need to say. In terms of what I do when it comes to Yu-Gi-Oh! Itself, like, you guys want to know where I get my little screenshots of the digital stuff? Here, I can leave right now off of YouTube and go straight to it. YGO Pro ES is my current form of it. I'm not going to enter it because it'll mess up the camera angle. It'll switch it to the side, but the side will still look like it's, in profile instead of landslides. And I'm not, my editing skills are atrocious. So I'm not going to press into it any further. But, I go in, I click through, make my decks, and go from there. And then I record off my DUR recorder, and then I go and upload it. If it's a physical deck profile, I just use my camera and go from there. When it comes to new stuff that I see, like a new hand trap, like the new hand trap when she got released, the way I do those videos is I go to whatever site has the information, mainly YGO Pro. And then I just do my synopsis video from there. Once I do that, I go on. When it comes to ban lists and stuff, go right straight to Yu-Gi-Oh's official website, go to the ban list section, and read it off from there. And record it off of DUR. Then I just send it to YouTube. From YouTube, I go to the shares, I go to my YouTube studio, I share it to my Instagram, my Facebook, my Twitter, and stuff like that. And, oh wow, I hit 59 subs. Thanks to anyone who's been subscribing. You guys rock. And like, that's just pretty much how I do it. I share it on my Facebook, I share it on Twitter, I share it on Instagram, and I try to keep you guys as updated with things as possible. And that's it. Let's go from there. So I want to thank you guys so much for hanging out with me and listening to this video and watching it and stuff like that. I will most likely be back later on today at the time of this recording, because I will be doing a live stream. It won't be Yu-Gi-Oh! Unfortunately, so sad face for those who were checking Yu-Gi-Oh! But for the most part, just like Puzzle and Dragons, Yu-Gi-Oh! Live streams had to hit their hold as well. I'm only live streaming because it is the celebration of the channel. But after that, that's pretty much about it. And I have my reasons for it. I'll probably clean in the live stream too. But yeah, that's pretty much the gist of it. So I thank you guys for coming and you guys for watching. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe, and share. So HPJ signing out. Thanks so much, you guys. Next time. See you next time.